Hello everyone, I am Anamika. Continuing our understanding reading comprehension series, in this lecture we will be discussing a new concept. And the new concept today is implications. Implication is one of the most not asked questions in the reading comprehension. You might find that the other types of questions like assumptions and inference have been asked a lot. But implications ka kabhi kabhi question aayega, sometimes it may not even come in the paper, or even if it comes, there is just one or two questions of implications. But despite that, it is very important for us to understand it, because even one answer, even one question that you have answered correctly in the question, in the test or in the examination can be a decider whether you qualify the exam or not. So let's try to understand what is an implications. So if we have to understand in simple terms what is an implication. So if you understand Hindi, implication means, the direct meaning of implication in Hindi is asar. Kisi cheez ka kya asar hoga? Agar maan lijiye barish hoti hai to uska kya asar hoga? Overall climate, weather conditions pe. Or if we go to see a simple meaning of it in English, it will be the effect. The effect of something. Theek hai? Toh kisi cheez ka asar ya effect, it can be anything. It can be something that the consequence that will happen of it. Or it can be something, the suggestions, that the steps that will be taken ahead. Very similar to corollary, I know, but it is a bit different. That we will be discussing ahead. Before we go ahead, from your understanding what we discussed now, let's solve one question and then we'll go ahead understanding it more. So I'll read out the passage for you. The Arctic's vast reserves of fossil fuel, fish and minerals are now accessible for the longer period in a year. But unlike Antarctica, which is protected from exploitation by the Antarctic Treaty framed during the Cold War and is not subject to territorial claims by any country, there is no legal regime protecting the Arctic from industrialization, especially at the time when the world craves for more and more resources. The distinct possibility of ice-free summer has prompted countries from Arctic coastline to scramble for great chunks of melting ocean. So here we see that the passage describing about the conditions of the Arctic and how, having no legal regime over it to protect the Arctic, the world, the countries that are bordering the Arctic have gone into, you know, negotiating or kind of a fight mode to get out of the resources that, you know, that can be seen after the ocean or the ice has melted there. Theek hai? So let's see what is the most important implication. Matlab, Arctic ka ye jo condition hai, uske wajah se uska kya impact hoga? या उसका क्या कॉन्सिक्वेंस होगा, उस चीज का क्या असर होगा, व्हाट विल बी द इफेक्ट ऑफ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन द पैसेज. लेट्स सी विच ऑफ द ऑप्शंस. इंडिया कैन हैव टेरिटोरियल क्लेम्स इन आर्कटिक टेरिटरी एंड फ्री एक्सेस टू इट्स रिसोर्सेज. सो इट इज नो वे टॉकिंग अबाउट इंडिया. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यहाँ पे एक इंडिकेटर है, फिर फ्री एक्सेस टू इट्स रिसोर्सेज. अब टेरिटोरियल क्लेम्स, अब इंडिया इट इज समवेयर आर्कटिक, उतना ऊपर जाके इंडिया कैसे टेरिटोरियल क्लेम कर लेगा? आई डोंट नो, बिकॉज दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द आर्कटिक कोस्ट लाइन हियर. ठीक है, सो दिस कैन बी एलिमिनेटेड. हाउ मच एवर यू फील अटैच टू दिस ऑप्शन बिकॉज इंडिया हैज बीन मेंशनड इन इट, इट इज नॉट वैलिड वन. ठीक है, मेल्टिंग ऑफ समर आइस इन द आर्कटिक लीड्स टू चेंजेस इन the geopolitics. So we can somewhere this can be an answer, because here what they are talking about, that the Arctic coastline countries are into a scramble for great chunks of the melting ocean. कि वहां से जो भी रिसोर्सेज निकलेगा आफ्टर द आइस हैज मेल्टेड तो दे विल बी हैविंग अ से ओवर इट. सो देर कैन बी सम एक्टिविटी इन द जियो पॉलिटिक्स ऑफ दैट रीजन. ठीक है, दैट कैन बी ऑप्शन, तो उसको हम रखते हैं अपने पास. द आर्कटिक रीजन विल सॉल्व वर्ल्ड्स फ्यूचर प्रॉब्लम ऑफ रिसोर्सेज क्रंच. दिस इज डिबेटेबल बिकॉज वी डोंट नो एनीथिंग अबाउट वॉट इज देयर इन द आर्कटिक और वॉट इज नॉट देयर, वॉट प्रॉब्लम्स इट कैन क्रिएट, वेदर इट कैन रियली सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ रिसोर्सेज क्रंच. नथिंग हैज बीन डिस्कस्ड हियर इन द पैसेज, सो वी कैन एलिमिनेट दिस ऑप्शन. ठीक है, द आर्कटिक रीजन हैज मोर रिसोर्सेज देन एंटार्क्टिका. इट्स नोवेयर गिवन हियर, और मतलब ये एक डेरिवेशन हो सकती इफ एट ऑल सम इंफॉर्मेशन वॉज गिवन आउट ऑफ देयर, बट देर इज नथिंग गिवन देयर एंड इट इज नॉट अ स्टेप और अ कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ वॉट इज गिवन इन द पैसेज. तो ये तो इम्प्लीकेशन तो ये पहली बात है ही नहीं, एंड ऑल्सो नोवेयर इज इट टॉकिंग अबाउट द कंपेरिजन ऑफ आर्कटिक और एंटार्कटिक. सो नाउ दैट वी हैव एलिमिनेटेड थ्री ऑप्शंस, सो दिस कैन बी द राइट इम्प्लीकेशन दैट जियोपॉलिटिक्स ऑफ दैट रीजन माइट चेंज द कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ आर्कटिक मेल्टिंग. ठीक है, सो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड अ बिट, लेट्स गो अहेड. सो वॉट इज एन इम्प्लीकेशन? सो इम्प्लीकेशन इज मोर इन द नेचर ऑफ कॉज एंड इफेक्ट. एज वी सॉ इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड दैट द पैसेज वॉज डिस्कसिंग अबाउट मेल्टिंग आर्कटिक एंड वॉट कैन बी द रिजल्ट ऑफ दैट. ठीक है, एंड सो वॉट वी सॉ इन द इम्प्लीकेशन दैट इट माइट ब्रिंग सम चेंजेस और सम एक्टिविटी इन द जियो पॉलिटिक्स ऑफ दैट रीजन. ठीक है, तो नेचर कॉज एंड इफेक्ट वाला होता है इम्प्लीकेशन. So let's understand what is a cause. Cause is a situation which is described in the passage, as we saw in the previous passage, a situation described and you will be asked to tell its effect or result. Uska result kya hoga? Wo pucha jayega as implication. Theek hai? Effect kya hota hai? Effect can be nature of steps that will take to solve the given problem. To steps kya liya ja sakta hai? या उसका कॉन्सिक्वेंस क्या होगा फ्यूचर में, वो आपका इम्प्लीकेशन देगा. सो हियर वी से बिकॉज ऑफ द रेनी वेदर वी कैंसल्ड द पिकनिक. कॉज क्या था? रेनी वेदर था, बारिश हो रही है, तो उसका इफेक्ट क्या हुआ? पिकनिक कैंसिल कर दिया. बिकॉज समथिंग हैपेंड, सो व्हाट एक्शन वॉज टेकन आउट ऑफ दैट, व्हाट स्टेप्स वर टेकन ऑफ आउट ऑफ दैट सिचुएशन, दैट विल बी योर इम्प्लीकेशन. ठीक है, लेट्स सी अ स्मॉल एग्जाम्पल ऑल्सो एंड हाउ टू सॉल्व इट. ठीक है, इफ अ क्वेश्चन इज आस्किंग यू टू प्रोवाइड द बेस्ट प्रैक्टिकल इम्प्लीकेशन, इट मीन्स दैट यू आर सपोज टू प्रोवाइड सॉल्यूशंस और सजेशंस टू द प्रॉब्लम और चैलेंज स्टेटेड, द स्टेप्स दैट नीड्स टू बी टेकन, दैट विल बी एन इम्प्लीकेशन, और द इमीडिएट इफेक्ट दैट यू सी out of the situation given, that will be an implication. But here there is a catch. Focus is more on the future. Corollary wale mein aapne dekha hoga, the focus is more on what is the immediate step or what is the present thing that can be done out of the situation. Implication ka hai ki always there the implication will be futuristic. Some suggestion or some step that can be taken in the future. ठीक है, लेट्स सी हियर. से देर हैज बीन एक्सेसिव रेन इन सम रीजन. सो एक्सेसिव रेन, सो ये कॉज हो गया. देन इट्स इमीडिएट इम्प्लीकेशन विल बी देर माइट बी फ्लड्स. ठीक है, बट वी आर नॉट लुकिंग फॉर दैट. इम्प्लीकेशन क्वेश्चन जब पूछता है तो व्हाट विल बी व्हेन इट इज आस्किंग अ प्रैक्टिकल इम्प्लीकेशन इन द क्वेश्चन इफ यू हैव सीन. तो प्रैक्टिकल इम्प्लीकेशन वो क्या होगा? विल बी टू बिल्ड डैम्स, टू टेक मेजर्स टू मिटिगेट द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ फ्लड्स. सो इफ यू कैन सी, दिस इज समथिंग दैट इज एन इमीडिएट थिंग दैट माइट हैपन बिकॉज ऑफ द रेन, बट दिस इज द स्टेप दैट नीड्स टू बी टेकन इन द फ्यूचर. सो सजेशन फॉर्म में होगा आपका इम्प्लीकेशन. ठीक है, सो फ्यूचरिस्टिक नेचर होता है इम्प्लीकेशन का, कोरोलरी का प्रेजेंट नेचर होता है, and implication may most of the times you have to give some suggestions or steps that can be taken. Theek hai? Let's try to solve a PYQ with this. In the immediate future, we will see the increasing commodification of many new technologies, artificial intelligence and robotics, 3D manufacturing, custom-made biological and pharmaceutical products, lethal automation, autonomous weapons and driverless cars. This will pose conundrums. The moral question of how a driverless car will decide between hitting jaywalker and swerving and damaging the car has often been debated. You will see how it has been debated. The answer is both simple. Answer is very simple, to save the human life, but at the same time it is also complex. At which angle should the car swerve, just enough to save the jaywalker or more than enough? If the driverless car is in Dublin, who would take the decision? The Irish government, or the car's original code writer in California, or a software programmer in Hyderabad to whom maintenance is outsourced? If different national jurisdictions have different fine print on prioritizing a human life, how will it affect insurance and investment decisions, including transnational ones? So as you can see, the situation here is talking about new technologies, about autonomous cars and how it can impact the well-being of a human being, and how taking a decisions that who will be responsible for the action that has been done by that technology will be a huge problem, because due to globalization, different works has been done in different parts of the world. So who will take the blame? So that is the question that has been asked in this passage. Let's see what is the question on it. So the question is, which of the following statements best reflects the, mark the keywords here, most reflects the rational, plausible and practical implications that can be derived from the passage. Let's see the options. ठीक है, रैशनल होना चाहिए आपका इम्प्लीकेशन, प्लॉजिबल होना चाहिए एंड प्रैक्टिकल होना चाहिए. ठीक है, इम्प्रैक्टिकल, प्रैक्टिकलिटी पे थोड़ा सा ध्यान देना, बिकॉज देल बी सम सॉल्यूशंस दैट माइट बी गिवन, सम ऑप्शंस दैट माइट बी गिवन विच मे नॉट बी प्रैक्टिकल, सो उसको भी एलिमिनेट करना है. ठीक है, टू मच ग्लोबलाइजेशन इज नॉट द बेस्ट इन द बेस्ट इंटरेस्ट ऑफ एनी कंट्री. So again, although we have seen that the paragraph talks about how different parts are developed in different parts of the world, it is not talking about the problems that globalization is creating. It is talking about the problem that automation or new technologies is creating. So too much globalization, the passage is nowhere talking about globalization, despite that this option is giving you globalization. So this can be totally eliminated. It is not something that has been given in the passage. Theek hai? Modern technologies are increasingly blurring the economic borders. As we saw that in different parts of the world, different things are being developed. So what is happening? We all are coming together and developing one product. So it is blurring the economic borders. So and how that is getting done? Through modern technologies. So it can be a correct implication. ठीक है, innovation and capital have impinged on the domain of the state. ठीक है, you can see that innovation, that is new technology, and capital, that is the things that are formed, have impinged on the domain of the state. So domain of the state has been talked in the entire paragraph, that who will take the blame if a technology does some mistake. So domain of the state is very questionable when we talk about innovation. ठीक है, तो एक ये भी option correct है. ठीक है, public policy of every country should focus on developing its own supply chains. So public policy on developing its own supply chain. So do you think it is a practical implication of that? should we, like, just because the autonomous cars may create a problem of autonomy of you know, who will take the blame, or you know, it will make things difficult, should we, like, just stop globalization and develop our own supply chain and not get connected with the other world? So it might not, it does not really, you know, suit or will not suit the technology or the development of new innovations. So we can eliminate this option, or if you want, keep it with you. Agar chahiye to isko, one of the options, if you are getting confused, isko rakhte hain, theek hai? Should develop on its own supply chains, which is quite a difficult task for any country to do, to be isolated in this globalized world. So practicality ki yahan pe situation aa rahi hai, theek hai? Let's go to the next option. Geopolitics will have to reconcile to many ambiguities and uncertainties. Ambiguities and uncertainties, why? Because who will take the blame? And geopolitics, the global geopolitical order, the all the leaders of the world need to think and find out methods about how we can reduce these uncertainties. Certainly, this is a step that needs to be taken in the future. So here you can see, this is a futuristic step. One of the implications that we think are correct, and modern technologies are increasing, blurring the economic border. So what is happening? Result ho raha hai iska kya? The modern technologies ka result ho raha hai ki blurring of economic borders. Innovation to iska kya hai? Domain of the state is being उसका impingement of domain of state is happening due to innovation and capital. Again, you can see it is a result of the, what was happening, the automation or innovation or technology that we saw in the paragraph. So these two things, as you can see, this is the consequence or effect. ठीक है? Effect or say impact of what was given in the passage. And this one, as you can see, this one is the suggestion or the step what should be done in the future, theek hai, to come out of the given difficult situation. Let's see the options. 1, 4, 5. So the first option is wrong, that we totally saw, because it is talking about globalization. So ye galat ho gaya. Again, we have option 1 here, ye bhi eliminate ho gaya. यहाँ पे भी अगेन फिर से ऑप्शन वन है, फिर से ही एलिमिनेट है. सो वी आर लेफ्ट विथ 2, 3, 5. सो 2, 3 एंड 5. सो यू कैन सी दैट टू थिंग्स दैट वी विल एबल टू पिन पॉइंट, दैट इज द कॉन्सिक्वेंस एंड सेकेंड विल बी सजेशंस. But the suggestions need to be futuristic. So, implication will contain of these two things generally. So, I hope you have understood what implication means. And it is a very simple thing. Zyada dimag lagane ki zarurat nahi hai. Totally situation diya hua hai and you have to see the result of it or what suggestions are there. One question, two question in the paper, go for it, solve it. It won't take much of your time and you will be able to easily earn those marks out of the implication question. So with this lecture on implication, we'll be ending our understanding reading comprehension series. I hope you all have understood all the concepts that we have discussed in all the videos throughout our series. I hope you solve questions based on those concepts. If you have any query, you can reach out to our office and we'll be able to solve it together. I hope you are able to qualify the examination with our help and your practice. All the best for your exam. I'll see you in some other series again. Thank you.